Good morning, students. Last time we had completed few exercises of chapter 18. Now let's continue. The going to form. When we use going to in a sentence, it means that the action is to take place in the immediate future or something will happen very soon. So what is the going to form? Going to form in a sentence shows us that action is going to happen very soon or in very near future. Formation of sentences using going to. How can we form a sentence using the form going to? First, we have to write the subject. Then, we have to write is, are, or am. Then, we have to write going to and plus first form of the verb. First form of the verb means original verb. So, in this way, we can form a sentence using the going to form. Exercise A. Rewrite the following sentences using going to. So, we have to use going to form and we have to rewrite the sentences. First, mother will cook food for the guests. So, here the verb is will cook and we have to use going to form. So, we will write mother is going to cook food for the guests. Second, it will rain today. So, will rain is the verb. We will write it is going to rain today. Third, I shall meet my grandmother today. So here shall meet is verb and we have to use going to. So we will write it as I am going to meet my grandmother today. 4. He will give all his books to poor children. Here will give is verb and we will write he is going to give all his books to poor children. Now exercise B. Fill in the blanks with the going to form of the verbs given in brackets. So in brackets we are given verb and we have to write them in going to form. First one, the shirt suits him. He is singular, so we will write is. Then we will write going to and then we will write buy. He is going to buy it. Second, she has missed the train. She is going to reach late. So we will write is because she is singular and reach is given. So we will write is plus going to plus original verb that is reach. Third, they do not like these books. They is plural. So we will write are. So the verb given is written. So we will write are plus going to plus original verb written. They are going to return them. 4. Gaurav is going to stay with his uncle because his parents have left for Chennai. So here verb was stay. Gaurav means boy is singular. So we will write is, then going to, then original verb stay. As Gaurav's parents are going to go to Chennai, he will stay with his uncle. Future continuous tense. The future continuous tense tells us about an action that will be in progress at a given point of time in the future. First of all, see over here, future continuous tense in that the word future is given means the action has not yet happened, it is going to happen. Continue means action will be going on. So, the actions which will be in progress or will be going on in future, they are all in future continuous tense. Such actions are written in future continuous tense. Example, Dholu and Golu will be playing tabla. So, they are yet not playing, they are going to play. So, will be playing. Formation of sentences in future continuous tense. If we wish to write any sentence in future continuous tense, how should we form that sentence? We should write the subject first. Then will or shall plus be plus first form of verb that is original verb plus ing ing. So example, Manisha subject, will be, write is the original verb and ing, so writing a letter. Manisha will be writing a letter. Exercise A. Change the following into future continuous tense. We have to write the following sentences in future continuous tense. First one, they are going to see the Taj Mahal. So over here verb is are going and what are we supposed to do? will be going. They will be going to see the Taj Mahal. We know with I and we use shall. With all other pronouns, subjects, we use will. So they will be going to see the Taj Mahal. Second, Monali was going to attend her cousin's marriage. Your verb is was going to attend. So we'll write will be going to attend. Monali will be going to attend her cousin's marriage. Third, Ruchi ma'am will teach us English. Ruchi ma'am will be teaching us English. So will teach will become will be teaching. Four, Jyoti will meet us with her mother. Jyoti will be meeting us with her mother. Here verb is will meet and we'll change it to will be meeting. 5. Neetu writes a poem for her mother. Neetu, she writes, so here simple present tense is used. She writes a poem for her mother. Neetu will be writing, means in future she will be writing a poem for her mother. 6. I visited the library in the evening. So here verb is in simple past tense, visited. We'll change it and we'll write will be visiting. So in the first sentence, I visited the library in the evening, in that sentence, it is being said that in the past, I had visited the library in evening. And when we have converted it, it says that I will be visiting, means I have yet not gone, but I'll go and visit the library in the evening. 7. The train arrived at 4:30 p.m. Train arrived at 4:30. The train will be arriving at 4:30 p.m. means train will come. It has not arrived yet. Now, in exercise B, fill in the blanks with future continuous tense form of the verbs given in brackets. Verbs are already given in brackets and we have to write them in future continuous form. First one, Mona. Mona means she. So we will write will be. Mona will be driving the car. Second, Shyam will be singing at the event. Shyam is boy, means he. So we can write will be. And with the verb sing, we'll add ing, so singing. So there is one event and Shyam will be singing at that. Third, Mr. Gupta will be teaching us maths. Mr. Gupta means he. So we can write will be and we'll add ing to the verb teach, will be teaching. 4. We. So we can write shall or will. We are going to write will. So we will be going to Mumbai during our holidays. When we will have holidays, during those holidays, we'll go to Mumbai. 5. They will be waiting for you at the stadium. They means few people. They all will be there at the stadium. They will be waiting for you. 6. The baby will be sleeping in the cot. Where will the baby be sleeping? In the cot. 7. Monali will be dancing in the function. 8. Nikita will be meeting me at the bus stop. So Nikita will come at the bus stop and she will meet me. Learn new words. Exercise A. Complete the paragraph with the correct words from the box. Few words are given in the box and we have to use them to complete this paragraph. A tsunami is a series of huge blanks caused by the undersea displacement of water, caused by an earthquake, volcano eruption, rock slides or other catastrophic events. So tsunami is a huge series. There are huge waves during tsunami. And why does this happen? Because water gets displaced. The reason behind water getting displaced is either earthquake, volcanic eruption or rock sliding, that is landsliding, or maybe some other events. When a tsunami hits a coastline, it can cause great destruction and loss of lives. So when these huge waves, they hit the shore or the coastline, they may cause great damage. Many tsunamis can be detected before they hit the land with the use of modern technology. So, nowadays we have technologies which can detect when a tsunami can occur. Tsunamis are sometimes incorrectly called tidal waves. We know that tsunamis are also known as tidal waves. Tsunamis are not caused by tides. Tsunamis are not caused by high tides or low tides. That's not the reason. In fact, tides are caused by the gravitational force of the moon. Moon has 1/6 gravitational force in comparison to Earth, and that gravitational force, it causes tides. So, this was the paragraph which you will be writing only in the textbook. Today we are keeping till here. I hope you have understood the concepts and the exercises I explained. Thank you.